Hello dear friends, in this video I shall take up an important topic which is used widely in all the mathematics concepts, and that is the topic of taking LCM. Now students use the traditional approach of finding the LCM which they study in the school, and they carry forward that method at competitive level also, thereby consuming a lot of time. So we need to have a method, or you can say a trick or basic understanding of LCM in order to find the LCM of numbers quickly. Normally when fractions or rational numbers are being added or subtracted, you need to take the LCM of denominators, and that's where we spend a lot of time. If you are ready with the LCM in 10 to say less than 10 seconds, then the problem can be solved very easily and quickly. So let's see how we can find the LCM of some numbers in a flash. I'll take up this video in three different parts. The first one is when we have divisors, like the numbers which are given here will involve divisors, like 12 is a divisor of 48, 3 is a divisor of 9, 9 is a divisor of 18, likewise 11 is a divisor of 44. In this case, the procedure is very, very simple. Then in case of co-primes, that is the numbers which do not have any common factor other than 1, like 7 and 10, they do not come in the table of any number except 1. So in this case also, finding LCM can be very easy. Like here also we have some co-prime numbers, here also these are co-prime. Now these are some primes, that means when the given numbers have one or two or more prime numbers, but not everything is prime. It may be that there is only one prime number, or it may be that there are two primes. Like here we have only one prime, here we have one prime, here we have two primes. So likewise, once you understand this concept, everything will be very, very easy for you. So let's get on with this. The first part we'll take up in case of divisors first. So in case of divisors, see, this is the first question, 12 and 48. We all know that if you count the table of 12, 12 ones are 12, 12 twos are 24, 12 threes are 36, 12 fours are 48. So we have this number 48, 12 divides 48 exactly. So in this case, the smaller number, that is the divisor, is not to be considered, and the LCM will be your other number, that is the multiple of 12. So 12 and 48, the LCM is 48 itself. You don't need to follow the traditional approach for solving this. Let's see this. Now see 3, 9 and 18. So when you have three numbers, just see whether there is any number which is dividing some other number. See, 3 exactly divides 18 and 3 exactly divides 9. So even if 3 divides one of these two numbers, then we have to eliminate the use of this 3. So we have to just forget this 3, because it is a factor of 18 and it is a factor of 9 also. Now if you see 9 and 18, 9 twos are 18. So like we did here, 12 fours are 48. We crossed out 12 and came out with the answer 48. Here also 9 twos are 18. So we have to just eliminate 9 and we have the final answer as 18. In case of three numbers like this, 11, 15 and 44, finding LCM can be a little tricky when you follow the traditional approach. But if you follow this method, then things will be very, very easy. See, 11 and 15, they are co-prime, so we can make use of this co-prime also, but simpler than that is this method, 12 fours are 48, likewise here we have 11 fours are 44. So 11 is a exact divisor of 44. So from these three numbers, we can just eliminate 11. So eliminate 11, you are left with only two numbers to deal with now. I will take up these two numbers, the final answer of this question, after I have told you this co-prime part. Now see 7 and 10. These two numbers, 7 and 10, they do not exist in the table of any number because their highest common factor is 1. They are not divisible by any number other than 1. So what happens in this case? Whenever the two numbers are co-prime, then their LCM is their product. So the simple answer, 7 into 10, 70. And you don't need to follow the traditional approach and just look at the numbers, find the LCM. Now, once you are aware of this method that whenever two numbers are co-prime, then their LCM is their product, you can use it here. Now see, 15 is, you don't need to factorize it, everybody knows that 15 is 3 into 5. So we have 3 and 5 here, but in 44, we have 2, 2 and 11. So there are no common factors between 15 and 44. Here we have 3 and 5 and here we have 2, 2, 11. So all factors are different. There is no common factor between them. That means these two numbers are co-prime. And whenever the numbers are co-prime, then their LCM is their product. So for this also, we just need to take the product. So for LCM of these three numbers will be 15 into 44, which will give you 15 fours are 60 and 66. So 660 is the LCM of these three numbers. Now continue with the co-prime part. Now see 5, 9 and 17. In this case, 5 is 5 itself. 9 is 3 into 3. There is no common factor between 5 and 9. And 17 is a prime number. So there is no common factor between all three numbers. Here we have 5, here we have 3 and 3, here we have 17. So the LCM of these three numbers will directly be equal to their product. So we have to just take the product of the three numbers and we will have our answer. And there is no divisor also. 5 does not divide 9 and 17, 9 does not divide 17. So we have to find the product now. So this is 5 into, and 17 into 9 is 153. So we just multiply, 5 is a 15, 26, 765. So here we have the answer, 765 as the LCM of 5, 9 and 17. Let's apply it here, 47 and 70. See, co-primes. Let's see 47. 47 is a prime number, not divisible by any number. So obviously 70 and 47 will not have any common factor between them. So their LCM will be equal to their product and you have the answer 3290 as the LCM of 47 and 70. Isn't it easy, friends? Knowledge of some basic things concerning LCM and you are ready with your answer just by giving a glance to the question. Let's see when there are prime numbers. Obviously here also we had some prime numbers, 5, 17. So you can consider both questions, both parts as one, but I meant to say co-primes here. That means no common factor between them. But here we have the common factors also. See, 10 and 15, they do have a common factor of 5. Now what happens when there are some prime numbers? Now see, whenever two numbers are there and one of them is prime, then the obvious LCM will be the product. But only one thing you have to check here. 11 is a prime number, but 11 is not a divisor of 14. So 14 and 11 do not have a common factor, and so they are co-prime, so the LCM will be their product. So 14 into 11, 154 is the LCM of 11 and 14. Let's apply the trick here, 3, 10 and 15. See, here we have a prime number 3, so in the LCM we will have 3. The prime number comes in the LCM directly if it does not divide other numbers. So here 11 was a prime number, but it did not divide 14, so 11 was taken in the LCM. Here 3 is obviously a prime number. Now you can do it two ways. I'll show you both the ways. See, if 3 is a prime number, you take 3, then you have to see 10 and 15. Now 10 and 15, the LCM is, see, 10 does not divide 15, so take multiples of 15. 15 twos are 30, now 30 is divisible by 10, So for 10 and 15, the LCM is 30. So here you have the answer 90. Now this is one way of doing it. Now in the other way, what you can do is, you can just eliminate this 3 and get on with 10 and 15. Now 10 and 15, 15 to the 30. Here we have the LCM 30. Can you tell me the difference why we are getting wrong answer here? That is because we have done this in case of divisors. We have to eliminate the divisor, but in this case we did not eliminate the divisor. So be careful, we should not follow this. So our answer for the question LCM is 30. Let it be a prime number. If it divides any other number, like 3 is dividing 15, you have to eliminate that number. But write it in the LCM if it does not divide the other number. So that is a very important fine point. That is why I have done it in both ways and told you why the first one is wrong. Now see 7, 9, 13 and 18. Here 7 is prime, 13 is prime, but 7 is not dividing any other number. 13, it does not divide any other number. Now, in the LCM, this 7 and 13 will find a place in the answer. And what we are left with is 9 and 18. For 9 and 18, obvious answer is 18 because 9 divides 18 exactly. So, we have to eliminate 9 and take care of 18 in the answer. And now you can just calculate this. This will be 13, 7 and 91 into 18. 18 ones are 18, so 8, 1 carry, so 162, 163. So 1638 is the LCM of these 3 numbers, rather 4 numbers, because 1 we have cancelled out already. So friends, this is the way you find LCM of numbers quickly, and if you follow this method, then obviously many things will go right for you. So friends, if you like this video, do share it and do not forget to subscribe the channel for more uploads to come in future.